Good morning, everyone. I'm Lauren Stone from Toy Wizards. That's toy-wizards.com. And I am back with another spontaneous toy review. So what I have today is we are going to review the Toy Story 4 Buzz Lightyear Model Kit from Bandai. I found this thing at my local Barnes & Noble where I buy tons of model kits. And their selection's fantastic. They're a little pricey, $4 to $60 depending, but it's a great place just to walk into a store and buy a model kit. I don't think a lot of people quite understand the level of toys that are available at Barnes & Noble. They have two sections. We have the kids section, that's where you find your LOLs and your Melissa and Doug and your Barbies and your Hasbro superhero, let's call them Barbie style dolls, and just things aimed toward kids. Then on the other side of the store, and of course this configuration is different depending on your Barnes & Noble, but on the other side of the store is like collectibles. So you'll find your CCG card games, and you'll find just tons and tons of Star Wars Kotobukiya toys. It's really weird. That's just, it's like this, it's like this Kotobukiya graveyard of Star Wars toys, and they're always on clearance, but like clearance, they're like $5 off. They're very expensive. But then there's a stack of Bandai model kits. That's where I bought my Astro Megazord from Power Rangers in Space. They have the Delta Megazord. They have tons and tons of Gundam kits, and they have the Dragon Ball Z kits. So when I found this Buzz Lightyear, I was totally excited, although I'm a Woody fan, so I gotta say that. There's no way to say I'm a Woody girl with a straight face, but I'm a Woody girl. No, but this toy is, I was definitely excited to review this, and I'm really glad I stumbled upon it in the wild, because when we covered these on Toy Wizards, I had sort of written a hopeful manifesto about how I was like hopeful that this would be children's level of difficulty and we could bring model kit building to the US and it could just be another hobby that kids do, like back in the day when you'd build an airplane or a ship or a model car with, you know, your dad or your grandpa. Could we return to that sort of slow building hobby lifestyle with your family? Ultimately, the answer is do whatever you want. But when I opened the kit and I was hoping to find something kind of geared toward kids, the answer is no. It is a standard model kit. The difficulty on this kit really is still in the, as I rate the Transformers kits by Flame Toys that we put together, I would still range this one in the high, easy, low, medium. It took me exactly on the dot 3 hours to build. Not 3 hours and then stickers. Like start to finish, stickers, everything was 3 hours to build. And here's the finished product. So when I do, look at his eyes. I want to talk about those eyes. When I do the follow-up write-up to this, that's where you're going to see pictures of my build and any sort of inch. Look at the Andy. Isn't that cute? The sticker came on it. The other one says Bonnie, the foot that he's standing on. So we'll talk about any specific snafus and we'll talk about specific weirdnesses with the build. While I'm doing the write-up, because again, I have all my pictures. I took a bunch of pictures, and so that's where the weirdness will happen. But we'll touch on a few things here. So his wings move. Like we have these parts that move out. They move up and down. Let me show you guys when to put him down. He's a little fragile. He's definitely, see the wings move and the secondary parts pop out. There's this trend right now with model kits where everybody wants them to be super articulated. And in terms of engineering and design, this is brilliant. And I am so wowed by the designers and the engineers and the artists' abilities to make model kits snap together and then articulate. But there's always a risk in that, like, these are not action figures. It's a model kit. So you're always gonna have like that one piece that doesn't fit together quite right. And so like the legs fall off. Like I think there's too much weight on his left foot there. Like he could very easily fall apart. I'm never gonna move him from this position. I am definitely one of those people where when I find a pose for my model kit, it's never moving again because it'll fall apart. For me, it'll always fall apart. I did, however, finally solve my left foot, right foot issue. So that'll never happen to me again in with model kit building. I've got a grasp on my left arm. It only took 20 years of model kit building, but I've got it. Let's see here. There was some really funny stuff in the directions on this. So his button, This has spring-loaded areas in the model kit. There's a couple, yeah, there's three springs that I had to kind of hook and carefully put together. There's a spring in the chest and then springs for the wings right there. But right here where he has the little button, like it thinks you can push it. It barely impresses. It doesn't do much, but in the directions it says gimmick check. And I just thought that was the best verbiage. Gimmick check. It is a gimmick. Pushing a button is a gimmick, especially on a model kit. And I was just like, is that the verbiage they use for, like, is that just Bandai's verbiage for, like, anything on a model kit that's not standard, like gimmick check? I just loved it. Oh my gosh, that should be my new band's name. So what was funny too, okay, let's talk about the box for a minute. Gorgeous, gorgeous packaging, perfect, on brand. Clean. It makes me feel terrible that I'm going to throw it away, because I am. I'm going to throw this box away. That's too bad, right? Let's talk about the face and the eyes real quick, because with spontaneous toy reviews, we're not going to, you know, we like to have a time frame for these. I don't want to keep on going and going. But so the thing is, one of the gimmick checks is Buzz Lightyear's eyes are supposed to move. And on paper, they were like, that probably sounded amazing. You have round eyes that you can pose in any direction. I would have just preferred a white eye clip that just snaps into the head and doesn't move, because these were incredibly difficult to put together. Buzz comes with three heads, and each one of those heads has corresponding eyes and facial expressions. Look, I put a picture of this on my social media. His eyes, just this face, and I wanted to use this face because I really liked the like smirk little, and I couldn't do it because the eyes wouldn't stay still. So I have, you know, people made jokes like Burr's Lurpier, you know, Derpier, like, and like I feel bad. It's funny, but it's not funny. But like his eyes won't stay in place. Like this was the only head he came with. This is a design flaw. I couldn't get it to stay still, which is honestly, so I couldn't use the head I wanted to. That's bad. And then let's go back to the finished kit. Even this one, his eyes are they're a little much. They're a little severe. He's a little wall-eyed. They will probably continue to slip down, and I don't know what it's going to look like in a few weeks if gravity has its way and his eyes just kind of keep falling. So this is what it looks like in the back with the crazy eyes. So yeah, instead of just this like eyeballs that you're supposed to put in there and then secure with this little gray piece, it looks like Mr. Potato Head. Like just give me two eyes on a clip, snap it in, put the gray thing on to secure, and we're done. Like that would have been enough. And it was one of those things where when I was talking to people about this model kit and people were asking, oh, I bought it, you know, what can I expect? And I'm like, the eyes are gonna give you hell. It's total crap. So in that regard, that is not a gimmick check that is working. Otherwise, let's see, we have one more head, Panic Buzz. So we have one more head there that I'm probably not gonna use. Another clip to secure the face. What else do we have? Several hands, we got more hands, his white gloves, and his eyeballs, which came on, see these tiny little circles? Those are his eyeballs. And then you put these little plugs. Let me show you. See this itsy bitsy thing right there? That goes in the eyeball. It plugs it up. Let's get better angle. It plugs it up, and then you put a sticker. See this right here? These little tiny, tiny blue stickers. That goes on the eyeball. So that's how you make the eyes go eye. Good idea, really odd execution. But with all that, Buzz Lightyear has, I love the shiny plastic. It looks perfect. I mean, you know, Disney Pixar is probably very, very, very insistent on, you know, approving the way their toys look. But yeah, I mean, it looks great. The stickers are excellent. The height, the size is wonderful. This looks like a doll. This looks like an action figure, and it's a model kit. So as far as like, if you want to buy a hobby kit for like a child who really loves this movie, and you're like, oh, I'll give him or her something to do, this may be a little much off the bat. This is not easy. But I will say this, when it came to the build, there were lots of parts that were just literal snapped together, and it was really, really easy, and it was really fun just to blast through all those pieces, and then the puzzle came. And then you blast through some, and then the puzzle came. So it really depends on the kid. Again, I never lie about my model kit abilities. I've been building models for 20 years and I'm just low medium. That's my threshold. Any more than 3-4 hours, I'm just not having fun anymore. I'm bored. It's torturous and I just need to go do something else. So it depends on, for some people it's really relaxing just to keep on going, but not for me. Again, this model kit, it was fun. The build was pretty straightforward. There were some aspects of it that I thought were some strange choices. I still give it 3.5 or 4 because it was easy, straightforward, it was fun, and there was nothing wrong with it happening here. So again, I'll give you guys some of the snafus in the write-up that'll come out this week. And otherwise, yeah, definitely recommend this one. If you are a fan of Bandai kits and you are a fan of Toy Story and you've been wondering, go get it. Go have fun. If I can go find the Woody one, I'll probably actually buy that one because that was the one I was more interested in. But Barnes & Noble only had 2 Buzz Lightyears. So thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. I'm Lauren Stone with Toy Wizards. That's toy-wizards.com. Check out all the content we're going to have over the week, every day. We update all the time. And I will see you guys soon. Have a great Monday and an awesome week. All right? Take care. Bye.